This is the Finesse Media Podcast.
Me, Miss E, and you're watching the Finesse Media Podcast, where there's always something brand new.
I'm so excited to have you here, and welcome back to another episode of the Finesse Media Podcast, Season 5. I'm your host, Ken Finesse Media, and as I mentioned to you right before the last episode, I'm going to bring you someone brand new, and this week I'm doing just that, and the honor and privilege as it is to have this great guest on, representing the none other devastating divas of Delta Sigma Theta. But it's not enough time to talk about the things that she is doing and have done as a mentor and as a life coach and as a professor and as a mom to many, as I was saying to her offline. But welcome to the podcast for the first time, joining us for this edition, this February edition. As you've been seeing last week and the weeks to come, I'm bringing on people that I believe that's finessing the game, but they're also, and just so happen to be, a part of the National Panhellenic Council, the Divine Nine. And again, joining me, representing Delta Sigma Theta by way of the Delta Theta chapter and the alumni chapter, Pine Bluff, and just a mother again of all, my queen, and much respect to and owe to so much. Welcome to the podcast, Mrs. Dovie Burl. How you doing, Mrs. Burl?
Hello, I'm great. How are you doing, Ken? Thank you so much for all of your beautiful accolades. I am just as proud to be here with you, because it is always the reward for educators to see their students and those that they've had a hand in their backs, yeah, do their thing and really walk in their ministry and life. So congratulations to you. Yeah. I'm honored and thank you so much.
Absolutely, Ms. Burl. As I'm rocking the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff, the alumni edition shirt. So again, yeah, so she's alumni. And you also had spent over a decade as being a professor on the campus of the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff. And she's also an alumni from the University of Arkansas at Little Rock, where she gained her master's degree from. So, I mean, Mrs. Burl, again, this episode is more about the Divine Nine, but you got to come back to talk about all your accolades and, again, the things that you've been doing and what we know you for and respect you for. So again, being a professor, but also being a co-founder of One Life at a Time, I want you to really talk about that before we jump into the whole Greek and the Delta thing. Talk to me about your organization that you co-founded.
Wow. So One Life at a Time, or OLOT as I call it, was given to me in a dream. And wow, one day I pulled up on the parking lot at the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff, where I worked for 17 years. And my colleague was getting out of his car, Michael Washington. And the two of us began chatting about the work that we were doing with so many students. And I told him I had a dream about what the organization would be called. And he said, well, what is it? And I said, it's OLAT, O-L-A-A-T, but I don't really know what it's going to stand for. And he just immediately said, One Life at a Time. Mm. And so, you know, that was our ministry, touching one life at a time, one student at a time. Mm. And so thus the organization was birthed. And so though it started on the campus of the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff with a few students, what we challenged them to do was to take it back into the world and to pull other students in and keep reaching back until they reach one life, yeah, at a time.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. Hey, Miss Bro, you have consistently done that. As I said, you're a mother to many. But I'm going to tell you this fun fact. And I don't know if I ever even told you this, but you have touched and motivated me before I even knew you. So I was a senior in high school in Chicago, And I used to just fan out for Pine Bluff. And I would go on YouTube. My aunt, rest in peace, my aunt Sylvia will be like, can you turn that radio off? You don't listen to that band every day. But it was a homecoming performance that I saw that really gauged me and attracted me to that school even more, is when you were performing. You were performing doing a homecoming halftime show. And I was like, I thought you were a celebrity. I mean, quite frankly, I think to many you are, because I mean, you are, again, connected with so many different people. But I saw you on that field show and you were performing, the band behind you. I was like, wow, who is this lady that's singing? And just even that tone, because you're also a singer too. So we're going to talk about that. But I was like, wow. And so then to meet you, that's when I was like, wait, that's the lady from the halftime performance. Mm-hmm. Do you remember that, Ms. Burl?
Well, So I did used to perform at halftime with the band. And let me just tell you a really quick fun fact. When the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff had their very first game against, I think it was Prairie View. Okay. And we had it in Little Rock and it was huge. I sang at halftime for the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff. And the group who is now known as In Vogue performed for Prairie View, but they were not In Vogue at that time. Mm. They were just students on the campus as I was. And so I had a chance to meet them before they ever became who they are today. And so let me just take this a little further. I don't know if you know this, but the way I even became affiliated with the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff was by way of singing. I received a full ride scholarship to go to college for singing under the leadership of the late Mrs. Shelton Fesser McGee. And so your gift will make room for you.
Wow. So you were in the Vesper Choir, did you?
I was all 4 years of my college career.
Okay. And as you said, that's some fun fact. So typically, again, in these editions, y'all know it, I've been kind of jumping right into the Greek, but this is a special, not just edition, but this is a special, special guest. So thank you for giving me that information. And again, I just want to, again, thank you for being just a great spirit and always welcoming and just making, particularly a lot of Chicago people too. Ms. Dovie Burl had a way of connecting with Chicago people, I think, more than anybody else on that campus. And I thought you were from Chicago at some point because of that connection. You know, us Chicago people can be a little bit tough to love, some of us. And you're thinking, we're young, right? We're 17, 18. So that's already there. But you had that connection like just immediately, and everybody just loved, particularly, again, Chicago folks. We love you. We love
the challenge was the fact that I learned that a lot of the students were hard to love, which made me want to really teach them how to love. And so, Chicago became like my second home. I made many trips to Chicago to either take students home for summer, or I was pulling up and saying, get in this car. Quitting is not an option. I did that many days. And so when they would see me pull up, they would say, Miss Burl, but you can't be hanging out, you know, in the hood. I said, but you're hanging out here. And I said, so the way you feel about me being here, I feel the same way about you. Mm-hmm. And so I think that I don't think you can serve people to the best of your potential if you have never stepped foot into their world.
Certainly.
And so in order for me to be able to serve students, I had to do that.
No, appreciate you for, again, not just being involved in Chicago and, you know, lives of students, but being in the city. Because, you know, a lot of people say, I ain't going to Chicago. You're going to get killed. No, Mrs. Burl, as you mentioned, fun fact, you had, I'm sure, the receipts to prove you were in Chicago, you know, for the good times, even for the bad times. I mean, my goodness, Ms. Burl was on the flight with our unfortunate passing with so many great brothers. Ms. Burl is right there, hands down, supporting and giving love to the family. So on behalf of the whole Chicago community, I say thank you, Dovie Burl. Thank you, Mrs. Dovie Burl.
You're very welcome. For sure, to God be the glory. And the one last thing I'll leave with you, the other fun fact is,
you ain't going nowhere. What you mean leave with me? You ain't going nowhere. We got more to talk about.
Okay, so Smokey Norful is my godbrother also.
I know. And can you tell him to call me?
Sure.
You said it, I didn't. I'm like, yeah, that's amazing. But go ahead.
Yeah. So my visits there, they often encompass spending time with him, but I always make sure that I connect with my former students, who I'm so proud of, because a lot of them now are married with children, and we're working on second generations. And so it's so beautiful to me. And so as long as I live and I can travel, I will always stay connected to the assignment that God gave me to do that.
Well, that's cool, Dovie Burl. I know, again, I'm from Chicago, but I'm in Dallas. You got to come and see me in Dallas and give some love to me in Dallas. I would love that. Let's have lunch or anything. And your family, your daughter, she's teaching in Fort Worth. So I think you'll be here.
Absolutely.
Let's think about that time that you got there to Delta Sigma Theta. And that's what, in part, you're here for. So talk to me, Mrs. Burl, about what made you join Delta? Because I'm sure being on campus, being in the Vesper Choir, you know so many people. And then what made you say, hey, I'm going to go ahead and join Delta?
All my mentors were Deltas. So all my life, I've had mentors that were more seasoned than I am. Most of my friends are more seasoned than I am, because I've always found it to be just a beautiful connection between someone who's like a sponge, which would be me, and really wanting to just take it all in from those who have been where I was going. So all my mentors were members of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority. And so when I assess my own life, and I began to see a lot of the work that the Deltas were doing, it aligned with my own life and, and the things that I did and wanted to continue to do. And so it drew me to want to be a part of Delta Sigma Theta. And I tell you, it has been one of the best blessings that I've experienced in life, because I have 300,000 plus sisters. Not that I know them all. However, it doesn't matter where I am. If I see crimson and cream with the letters Delta Sigma Theta on them, it's as if we have known each other all of our lives.
And that's what I love most. And I have said this probably on the last episode or the episode before, just with talking with other Greeks. That's one of the cool things. And quite frankly, you don't even have to see another crimson and cream. If you see, you know, purple and gold, if you see blue and white, that divine nine connection is just really unique. And so I detest when people say that we are like the devils and all those kind of things. I'm like, whoa, you don't even understand the love and the connection and the authenticity, where people just really do it just because you're either an HBCU alumni, or if you're Delta, or if you're also just another member of a fraternity, that connection is just automatic. But when you think about Delta Sigma Theta, what do you love most about the sisterhood?
We're founded on Christian principleship. So when you just made the statement that there are those who think that we, this is kind of like devil's work, that is so far from the truth, because most All of us are founded on Christian principleship. And so I believe all of us are doing the will and work of God in our communities with people who look like us. Absolutely. And so that's our sole purpose, is to bring service to all mankind, and especially to go into our neighborhoods and better our neighborhoods by making sure that we extend servitude, gratitude to all of those that are less fortunate than we are, and even those who may just need a guidance on the pathway. And so what I love most about Delta Sigma Theta is that the camaraderie of the sisterhood is so strong, and the unity is so beautiful. And I got some sharp sisters. Oh my God. Some of the sharpest that I have ever seen. And so just to be connected to that, it just gives me a feeling of thankfulness, of gratitude. And I'm proud. To be a part of my sorority.
Yeah. And just keeping it going, when you think about so many of your sisters who are doing amazing things and who are perhaps finessing the game, as I say on this platform, but keeping that going each and every week on this episode or on this platform, Mrs. Burl, I talk to my finesses. Who are you? That person that I believe that's finessing the game. But within your sorority, Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, who's that person that comes to mind? Who's that one person that comes to mind for you when you say she is finessing the game and she's my sorority?
That is so unfair because there are so many.
Yeah, I know it's an unfair question. Yeah. But who comes to mind for Mrs. Dovie Burl?
Fast Time Murphy. She is just because she is a legacy of one of our founders and named after her grandmother. And she is the most powerful first female Black bishop in the AME church.
And I want to make sure my viewers heard it. So repeat her name one more time.
Vashti Murphy. She is something to be reckoned with. And so when I see powerful women who have prayed all over the world, from Africa to the Pope to you name it, when you look at women like that who can finesse the world, she can finesse her way with any level of dignitary. Oh my God.
Okay. You gave me some homework, because now I want to know more about her. You definitely gave me some homework. Yeah.
Yes.
So shout out to her that's finessing the game. But when you think about being in the sisterhood and sometimes your same chance to maybe just not shed light or throw shade, as they say, on other organizations, but then you also have chance that you say to amplify your principles and the love for your organization. So when you think about Delta Sigma Theta, Mrs. Dovie Burl, what's one of your favorite chants that comes to mind? Because I see you out there strolling, Dovie Burl. Mrs. Burl, you're not out there just, you know, watching these people. You're in line. I've seen you, and you're not growing grass underneath your feet. You're back out there. You're back out there. And you never left, I should say.
I guess one of my favorite chants is when we all get together, especially at homecoming, and it's Ola Ola. It's something about when we get together and we show you what a real Delta looks like.
Yeah.
And so I'm not gonna go too much into the words, but it's just beautiful to me to see just the unified just when you see all those women lined up and doing our strut and doing our thing, it's not just something we do for show, but it is because we have really, really studied and we understand the purpose of our being in the sorority. And so that is that's just so great for me. Yeah,
it's a good feeling. Happy belated Founders Day, by the way.
Thank
too.
You.
How rude thank of me! I should have started or led with that. But yeah, okay, and that I think when you said that, it just reminds me of Founders Days, because it seems like you get that rededication, that reaffirmation, and the love for your sorority and for your fraternity, because you're going, wow. And I'm not going to ask, but I am going to ask, how long have you been a member of Delta Sigma Theta? What was your line number and what was your line name?
So this will mark my 25th year in April.
Okay.
And I'm very excited about that. My line name was Sapphire's Dove, and I was number 17.
There you go. That's two 17s for this season, by the way.
Okay. And our line was the Millennium 21. And you know what was so beautiful? We were turning into Millennium, the 21st century. And so that's came up with our line name. But I'm talking about shark sisters that were doctors and lawyers and police chiefs. And, you know, I was on the line with them, right?
Wow. Yeah. Well, they were on the line with you, Dovie Burl. And what an honor, I'm sure it was, to be a line sister of the Dovie Burl. I mean, you are so humble and I love it so much. Y'all, listen, she is holding back. And that's why she got to come back, because we really got to take away from the Delta brand, but talk about the Dovie Burl and the things that she's done and the people that she's impacted over the years and what she's continued to do. So you have to come back on this podcast.
I will. And so, you know, what I do want to tell you is when I I was a professor and I moved from academic affairs to student affairs. And so my very first encounter with the Greek organizations undergraduate, which was very different from what I was used to. But my very first encounter was at Miss UAPB's coronation. And so though I had to set precedent for all the organizations because I really wanted the undergrad to understand what their purpose really is. And I had to come in a little hard, but I will tell you that of all of the Divine Nine, the Sigmas were.
Oh, stop it, Miss Burl.
No, I really mean this. And if you ask Michael Washington.
No, she's for real, y'all.
Yeah. Seriously. But when I say the most respectful, the most organized and unified brotherhood, and it could have very well been because of the leadership that you all had in your advisors. Yes, but I met your international president at a service one day, and his sister-in-law happened to be my sorority sister and my favorite Delta. Okay. But anyway, he took this card out of his pocket and he said to me, Dovie Burl, it is really nice to finally meet you. He said, if you ever have any problems with my brothers, he said, you take this card, drop it on the ground and tell one of them to pick it up and you'll never have another problem.
No, and I can certainly believe that. No, Mrs. Burl, you're right. I mean, I remember, and again, just full transparency, I was on campus and you're looking at the Dovie Burl was our dean for our Divine Nine. And so, no, as you mentioned, you came in pretty tough. You came in pretty tough, though. But I understood because, you know, your predecessor didn't take it. And she stood, Shirley Jacobs, shout out to Shirley Jacobs. Yeah. I mean, what she did for that campus and the foot, you know, prints that you were walking in behind her, but you also set your own path. And you know, that people knew that Dovie Burl, but you had to set that fine line. Like, listen, I'm Mrs. Dovie Burl, y'all, but I'm also, you know, the dean, you know, of student life. So, no, I respected that so much.
And I took that title, and I know we're not talking about this, but I can't have a discussion with you without sharing this. I wasn't just the dean of student involvement and leadership. I was in loco parentis. I was serving in the place of parents who were not there. Mm-hmm. And I was responsible for their children, whether they were young adults or not. Yeah. I was held responsible for other people's sons and daughters.
Yeah, that's why I say thank you. And that's no lie. That's no lie. There's people that you will see in this comment, in this episode, that will be saying the same thing and maybe giving so many thank yous for sure, because this woman is not lying. When I tell you she's selfish and had her own kids, but still looked at the campus as her seemed like biological children, 100%, for sure. We thank you, Ms. Burl, for sure.
You're welcome. For doing that. You're very welcome.
Before I get
I've told my children many times over, thank you for sharing me with so many. I really appreciate that. And I hope that what they learned from that is that you have to give of yourself all through your life. Mm-hmm. You have to give of yourself. That's why we were created. So.
Yeah. And then your son, Danny Burl, just came on campus and became a star. He just became everything his mother was. Shout out to Danny Burl, an amazing talent, an amazing artist, an amazing musician. I mean, he came on campus and just stole the show. I was like, well, of course. Do you know who his mom is?
Well, thank you so much. I'm very proud of both of my children. And
I bet you are. Yes, I bet you are. You did an amazing job and still doing an amazing job, because I'm sure they still call the mom for advice. They're like, mom.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Yes. Before I get you up out of here, Mrs. Burl, each and every week on the podcast, what I'm doing with my Finesse and my guests, I am looking through your social media pages, or I'm looking through your Snapchats if you got it, but I'm trying to figure out, what was this about? What was this photo or the video, or what was the status you posted was all about? So it's something I found on your social media.
Oh my, what was it?
Yeah, y'all thought Mrs. Professor was a perfect. No, I'm kidding. No, let me tell you what I found, or show you what I found. And you let me and my audience know, what was this photo all about? You ready?
Okay. Yes, I'm ready. Here you go. I guess. Oh, that's my love joy. That's my sweet thing there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my husband of 35 years this year. And thank you. And I'm taking this back to the beginning of our conversation when I came to the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff at 17.
Wow.
he swept me off my feet at 18 and I married. And so I was the only choir member who was married.
Wow. At 18.
And so at 18. And Mr. Shelton McGee, when we would take tours and we toured all over the United States, I could not stay in the hotels with all of the single people. I had to stay wherever he stayed.
Wow. Because he had to make sure.
Old school.
Yeah. Old school. It's like, you're a married woman. Yeah. Yes. But I saw that photo, Mrs. Burl, and I said, man, what a lovely photo. I mean, I know that, you know, you've been married for so long, but I'm looking at this and I'm like, how old were you all? Because ain't nobody aging. Like, goodness.
Yeah, we're aging.
Y'all in that old glass, you know, champagne photo too. So that's a super nostalgic photo in itself. Oh, man, just look at it, though. Amazing, amazing. But no, thank you for sharing the story behind the photo. And that's what I
wanted to absolutely. Yeah. I appreciate him so much because I couldn't do the work that I do without the support I have from him. Yeah. He just allows me to be, and that's it, you know? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm always watching for the next thing that Ms. W. Burl is doing. The motivation in the morning is what I look forward to.
Thank you.
I'll tell you that. So keep that going. I love
Thank you.
That because it definitely makes a difference in my day when I see it. But what's next? Anything that you're working on, anything you'd like to share? I'll tell you this before you say anything. Your festival, that's a whole nother episode. I know you got to come back and talk about it. I am going to be there next year. So hopefully you're about to tell me that that's what you're planning. But what's coming up next?
Yeah, I absolutely am. So we are working on the Summer Breeze Festival. This year, we're excited because it's going to be an entire weekend. We have Saturday Summer Breeze Jam Fest, and then Sunday Summer Breeze Jazz Fest. So yes, and we do it at our home at the Burl Estate, and so it's growing by leaps and bounds. The other thing I do is a Christmas home tour where I invite school children and their families to come to just a really wholesome Christmas adventure. And I have one more thing I'm working on that I can't quite share yet. I'm still praying about it. But once I get it underway, then those will be my three events that I will do probably for the next 10 years. And then I'm going to go and sit down somewhere.
You ain't sitting down. No, you're not sitting down. No. Surgery couldn't keep you down. You're back on your feet and you're moving and you're finessing the game. But no, your festival, much love to it, because when I saw the pictures from it, I was like, wow, I wish I could have been there. I think I was in Minnesota for a family reunion, but all of the photos that you shared, I mean, people came out, you had artists there, you had vendors there, and then you just said something I didn't know. This was in the back of your home?
Yes.
Oh my goodness, that was a lot of land.
Yes. So this is our third year, and it springed from my 50th birthday a few years ago. Yeah. I had a 3-day party, and day two was a day party, and so many people came with their families. I said, we've got to do this. This has got to be for the community. And so that's how we got started with it. So it's been exciting, and I'm just looking forward to what's next and what's next. So I'm currently a consultant with Arkansas State University. So I train teachers, administrators, superintendent, boards all over the state on positive behavior intervention and support. That's another show you and I will have to talk about.
Okay.
I think I'm going to ease my little self right on out of the work world at the end of the year and retire.
Yeah. And sit back. Yeah. That's what's up, Ms. Burl. I mean, you deserve it. And let your flowers continue to come. No, that's it.
I've been 30+ years in the game.
For sure. Yeah. Finesse in the game. And we'll continue to encourage you and support you in any way that we can. Her information is right there at the bottom, y'all. But listen, Mrs. Dovie Burl, thank you so much for joining this episode, for making this edition great, for making the Divine Nine edition great, and representing Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated in the best way, for sure.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you. I love you with my whole heart.
I love you so much, Ms. Burl. Love you forever, forever, forever. I love you so much. There's nothing you can do about it.
Yeah, all right. I don't want to.
All right, you guys, you've been watching another episode of the Finesse Media Podcast, Season 5. I'm your host, Ken Finesse Media, and I'll see you next week with something brand new and with another Greek. So here we go. We're going to keep this thing going all February month long. Make sure you subscribe, comment, share this episode, share with your sorors or with your fraternity brothers or with anybody that needs encouragement, because that's exactly what Ms. Dovie Burl is going to continue to do, is give you support and love. Make sure you support and subscribe or do whatever you need to do to be in contact with this queen. Thank you so much, Dovie Burl.
Thank you.
Enjoy the rest of your night.
Thank you. You too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
This has been another edition of the Finesse Media Podcast. Join us again next week for the latest news from HBCUs. Special guest.